Hello everyone, welcome back to GK Code Labs. So in this session, actually I have got a very interesting use case in big data, and that is sort of related to nested JSON. So it is a sort of a use case that you can say will go within 2 or 3 videos, but at least for this session, I have brought you the techniques that you should keep in mind while traversing through a nested JSON. So we'll be seeing how we can read a nested JSON and what are the first things that we should keep in mind while accessing those nested JSON elements. And in upcoming videos, we'll also be seeing some more complex requirements on top of the same use case. This all nested JSON use case videos, all the code that we'll be writing into it will be pushed to our collaboration branch in the Git that all our extended plan members have access to. So you can anyways pull and you can even code your approaches and share us back so that we can discuss in case anyone pushes it. Similarly, we'll make the this complex requirement discussed all on this video sessions. And maybe these all videos could help you in some way. The code will be available in our extended plan shared repository. So let's see how we can traverse through our nested JSON. So in this video, we'll be seeing how we can handle the nested JSONs in our Spark program. So there is a sample JSON. This data I have copied from Kaggle. I'll mention the link for this file package in the description of this video. So I'm taking this file 5 as this is the smallest in this package that I could see. So you can see there is only one line, but in the end you can see it's almost 669,000 something characters. Let me wrap it. So this is our JSON. So it's very complicated to look at this in a raw format. So let me read it using the Spark read JSON method, and then we will get into its complexities. So just a normal read method, spark.read.json. And let's see what we get in our JSONDF. We'll do a show and also the schema of it. So there you can see this is our data frame, okay, which has some columns and some data. That one line JSON turned out to be something complex, but anyways, let's see the schema of it. So it has basically on the root level, it has code, messages, restaurants, which is an array of a struct. Then again, restaurants again are a struct, which has again struct of many things. So this is sort of a different level of hierarchy that this JSON is going into. Now, what I want you to understand in this video, as a part of this video, is how do you traverse through different level of hierarchies in a JSON. So to traverse through that, you need to understand first the type of every first level component. So this first level component is obviously the columns that you are getting. That is, you can see a code, message, restaurants, and let's see results found, shown, and all this status. So if you see in this code, messages, restaurant, that is the first level columns that you are getting. Okay, and other also, I think after this long JSON, you'll be getting somewhere. Results found, results shown, results run, and status. Okay. So to traverse through that, there may be the requirements that I need the restaurants in some other table. Let's say you have to populate a data frame and you have to load it into Hive table. So you need restaurants into some other table, and let's say on the second hierarchy you need the restaurant R into some other table, and similarly it's a small, or let's say you can say restaurants establishments, you want all of this into another table, or the address into another table. So you have to anyways traverse through this. So to traverse through this, you can see I cannot, I have the detail of restaurants, but it's not very clear for me what is this, what all is this. Although I need, I know that it will have, restaurants will have something called as restaurant level and the API keys, and how do I get this? So for this, you need to understand that what is this, it long and string, the generic data type, that's fine. But when it comes to the arrays, how can you get the restaurants level at the root? So in that case, to traverse till different structures, you need to keep two things in mind. Once, you need to flatten this array wherever you have it. Maybe this JSON can go far more, but wherever you have an array, in case you need that particular column, what you need to do. So from this JSON data frame, well, let's say I want to have a restaurants data frame. Simply what I need to do is, from this I need to traverse till this, that is my restaurants. So I can select JSON DF dot select restaurants. Now this is an array. Even if I select as it is right now, I won't be getting much value out of it. Let me show you. So I'll do restaurants. Okay. Although I have selected the restaurants, so you can see this restaurants came at the root level, but although it still has multiple elements, but still here I am getting something which as a value I'm getting, but I cannot make it out what is this. In this restaurant I have the element struct which has restaurant, which has API key. What is all this? Can you figure out from this? No. Yeah, while going through comma and comma maybe, but I cannot figure out. So when it comes to arrays, what you have to do is explode. Just keep in your mind, wherever you see arrays, if you want to see all your data, you have to do explode. I'll tell you the reason why. So if I do, this restaurant is an array, if I do an explode, here, and explode expects, it is giving the error because it expects a column, so that we can cast it with call API. Let me run it now. Okay, so you can see while after the explode you will see a random column as call, that is Spark internal thing, but at least in that you will see your different data in that JSON as a call. Okay, you'll see, you'll say that still I cannot make much out of it. Okay, fine, it's fine, only call you are getting, right? But look at the schema, the array is gone because you exploded it. Now second level, when it comes to struct, how you can gather all the elements of a struct. Struct is
having different columns like this and all the separate keys as the different elements which you can access by the names of it. Let me show you an example. This call I have, right? If I do on top of this, if I do dot select, I have a call dot everything, let's say everything. Okay, now you can see you are at the restaurant level and you have restaurant, but restaurant is again a struct. So although you will be having all the details here, but till the time you have struct and you want to go inside it, you will have to do a star. So right now I have got the restaurants. What I can do is call, I can do dot select restaurants star, or I can do call dot restaurants. It's fine, it's the same thing. Sorry, I didn't do dot. Let me stop it. So you can see we are at the level inside our restaurant, and soon after that you can see I have got all the required columns, API keys and the actual values that were inside it. They were separated just by commas, but now you can see them exactly in a data frame. This is my events URL. This is my featured image, if at all that exists, and all the respective columns, right? So this is how you can traverse through a nested JSON. Now, there is a requirement that you have to populate, let's say, 10 further tables from one JSON. And also on top of that, there can be a requirement that there might be some of this field missing. Like from this, there might be some fields missing, and there is a standard schema, let's say the created by or created timestamp, that has to be there. And you have the requirement that if it is there, you have to take it, otherwise you have to add on to it. So there is such complex requirement that I'll be discussing in my next video. But as a part of this video, I hope you were clear how you can traverse through a nested JSON. Thank you guys, see you later.